The Lord be with you.
And
welcome, good friends and guests, in the name of the crucified God, Jesus Christ, and a special welcome and expression of great affection to all the musicians, our reader, and the media tech support who have worked hard to prepare for this night's worship. Let us pray. Merciful God, your Son was lifted up on the cross to draw all people to himself. Grant that we who have been born out of his wounded side may at all times find mercy in him, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Blessed is the kingdom of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and always, forever and ever. In peace, let us pray to the Lord. Peace from on high, and for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and protect us, O God, by your grace. Thank you.
So Judas brought a detachment of soldiers, together with police, from the chief of priests and the Pharisees. And they came there with lanterns and torches and weapons. Then Jesus, knowing all that was to happen to him, came forward and asked them, "Whom are you looking for?" They answered,
"Jesus of Nazareth."
Jesus replied, "I am he." Judas, who betrayed him, was standing with them. And when Jesus said to him, "I am he," they stepped back and fell to the ground. Again, he asked them, "Whom are you looking for?" And they said,
"Jesus of Nazareth."
Jesus answered, "I told you that I am he. So if you are looking for me, let these men go." This was to fulfill the word that had been spoken, "I did not lose a single one of those whom you gave to me." Then Simon Peter, who had a sword, drew it and struck the high priest's slave and cut off his right ear. The slave's name was Malchus. Jesus said to Peter, "Put your sword back into its sheath. Am I not to drink the cup that the Father has given to me?" And so the soldiers, their officer, and the Jewish police arrested Jesus.
Thank you.
He went with Jesus into the courtyard. But Peter was left standing outside the gate. So the other disciple, who was known to the high priest, went out and spoke to the woman who guarded the gate and brought Peter in. And the woman said to Peter, "You are not also one of this man's disciples, are you?" And he said, "I am not." Now the slaves and the police had made a charcoal fire, for it's cold. And they were warming themselves. And Peter was standing with them and warming himself. And then the high priest questioned Jesus about his disciples and about his teaching. And Jesus answered, "I have always spoken openly to the world. I have always taught in the synagogues and the temple where all the Jews come together. I have said nothing in secret. Why do you ask me? Ask those who heard what I said to them. They know what I said." And when he had said this, one of the police standing nearby struck Jesus, and he hit him in the face, saying, "Is that how you speak to the high priest?" And Jesus answered, "If I have spoken wrongly, testify to the wrong. But if I have spoken rightly, why do you strike me?" And then Annas sent him bound to Caiaphas, the high priest. And Simon Peter, standing, warming himself, they asked him, Then Pilate took Jesus and had him flogged. And the soldiers wove a crown of thorns and put it upon his head. And they dressed him in a purple robe. And they kept coming up to him, saying,
"Hail, King of the Jews."
And striking him in the face, Pilate went out again and said to them, "Look, I am bringing him out to you, let you know that I find no case against him." the Jews, "Here is your king." And they cried out,
"Away with him! Away with him! Crucify him!"
And Pilate asked them, "Shall I crucify your king?" And the chief priests answered,
"We have no king but the emperor."
Then he handed him over to be crucified. So they took Jesus, and carrying the cross by himself, he went out to what is called the place of the skull, which in Hebrew is called Golgotha. There they crucified him, and with two others, one on either side, Jesus between them. Pilate also had an inscription written and put on the cross. It read, "Jesus of Nazareth, King of the Jews." Many of the Jews read this inscription because the place where Jesus was crucified was near the city, and it was written in Hebrew, in Latin, and in Greek. The chief of priests said to Pilate, they took his clothes and divided them into parts, four, one for each soldier. And they also took his tunic. Now the tunic was seamless, woven in one piece from the bottom to the top. And so they said to one another, "Let us not tear it, but cast lots to see for whom we'll get it." And this was to fulfill what the scripture says, "They divided my clothes amongst themselves, and for my clothing they did cast lots." And that is what the soldiers did. Meanwhile, standing near the cross of Jesus were his mother and his mother's sister, Mary, the wife of Clopas, and Mary Magdalene. When Jesus saw his mother and the disciple whom he loved standing beside her, he said to his mother, "Woman, here is your son." And then he said to the disciple, "Here is your mother." And from that hour, the disciple took her into his own home. And when Jesus knew that all was finished, he said, in order to fulfill the scripture, "I am thirsty." A jar full of sour wine was standing there. So they put a sponge full of wine on a branch of hyssop and held it to his mouth. And when Jesus had received the wine, he said, "It is finished." Then he hung his head and gave up.
it was the day of preparation. The Jews did not want the bodies left on the cross during the Sabbath, especially because the Sabbath was a day of great solemnity. So they asked Pilate to have the legs of the crucified men broken and the bodies removed. Then the soldiers came and broke the legs of the first and the other who had been crucified with him. But when they came to Jesus and saw that he was already dead, they did not break his legs. Instead, one of the soldiers pierced his side with a spear, and at once blood and water rushed out. He who saw this has testified, so that you too may believe. And his testimony is true, and he knows that he tells the truth. These things occurred so that the scripture might be fulfilled. None of his bones shall be broken. And again, another passage of the scripture says, they will look upon the one whom they have pierced.
After these things, Joseph of Arimathea, who was a disciple of Jesus, though a secret one, because of his fear of the Jews, asked Pilate to let him take away the body. Pilate gave him permission, and so he came and removed his body. And Nicodemus, who had first come to Jesus by night, also came, bringing a mixture of myrrh and spices, weighing about 100 pounds. And then they took the body of Jesus and wrapped it with the spices and linen cloths, according to the burial custom of the Jews. Now there was a garden in the place where he was crucified, and in their garden there was a new tomb where no one had been laid. And so, because it was the Jewish day of preparation, and the tomb was nearby, they laid Jesus.
Let us pray, people of God. For the church throughout the world, Almighty and eternal God, you have shown your glory to all nations in Jesus Christ by your Holy Spirit. Guide it throughout the world. Help it to persevere in faith, proclaim your name, and bring the good news of salvation in Christ to all people. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us pray for those preparing for baptism. Almighty and eternal God, you continue to bless the church. Increase the faith and understanding of those preparing for baptism. Give them new birth as your children and keep them in the faith and the communion of your church. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us pray for our siblings who share our faith in Jesus Christ. Almighty and eternal God, you give your church unity. Look with favor on all who follow your Son. Make all the baptized one in the fullness of faith, and keep us united in the fellowship of love. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us pray for the Jewish people, the first to hear the word of God. Almighty and eternal God, long ago you gave your promise to Abraham and your teaching to Moses. Hear our prayers that the people you called and elected as your own may receive the fulfillment of the covenant's promises. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us pray for those who do not share our faith in Jesus Christ. Almighty and eternal God, gather into your embrace all those who call out to you under different names. Bring an end to inter-religious strife and make us more faithful witnesses of the love made known to us in your Son. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us pray for those who have not yet embraced God. Almighty and eternal God, you created humankind so that all may know you and find peace in you. Grant that all may recognize the signs of your love and grace in the creation and in the lives of your people, and joyfully embrace you as the giver of healing, of meaning, and of life. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us pray for God's creation. Almighty and eternal God, you are the creator of a magnificent universe. Hold all the worlds in the arms of your care and bring all things to fulfillment in you. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us pray for those who serve in public office. Almighty and eternal God, you are the champion of the poor and oppressed. In your goodness, give wisdom to those in authority so that all people may enjoy justice, peace, freedom, and a share of the goodness of your creation. We ask this through Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And let us pray for those in need. Almighty and eternal God, you give strength to the weary and new courage to those who have lost heart. Heal the sick, comfort the dying, give safety to travelers, free those unjustly deprived of liberty, and deliver your world from falsehood, hunger, and disease. Hear the prayers of all who call on you in any trouble, that they may have the joy of receiving your help in their need. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Finally, let us pray the prayer that our Lord taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name.